Cushion reflex usually observed in patients with acute head injury because acute head injury causes increase in intracranial pressure. And increased intracranial pressure causes development of so-called Cushing triad, is hypertension, irregular breathing, and bradycardia. And exactly these three symptoms from Cushing reflex. The mechanism of Cushing reflex is that acute head injury causes increase in intracranial pressure. The concept is that cerebrospinal fluid is located in a closed space because this space is surrounded by the skull. So fluid can't rapidly leave this space, nor it can distend this space. And if due to some reason, for example acute head injury, there is increase in cerebrospinal fluid production or decrease in space volume, it inevitably leads to increase in intracranial pressure. The problem is that if intracranial pressure becomes greater than mean arterial pressure, which is basically average blood pressure during cardiac cycle, cerebral arterioles become compressed. The radius of arterioles decrease, and because resistance is inversely proportional to the force power of radius, with decrease in radius, resistance of cerebral arterioles increase, and increase in resistance causes decrease in blood flow through them. Because recall that blood flow is equal to pressure difference divided on resistance, so with increase in resistance, blood flow decrease. So if intracranial pressure becomes greater than mean arterial pressure, brain perfusion decrease, and this causes ischemia of brain tissue. Cerebral ischemia causes immediate increase in partial pressure of carbon dioxide and decrease in blood pH in cerebral circulation. It activates medullary chemoreceptors, then in response to this, immediately increase sympathetic nervous system outflow. First of all, this causes systemic vasoconstriction that increases systemic vascular resistance. Also, it stimulates sinoatrial node, this causes increase in heart rate, and it increases cardiac contractility, and this causes increase in stroke volume. As we know, stroke volume multiply on heart rate, its cardiac output, and cardiac output multiply on systemic vascular resistance determine mean arterial pressure. So activation of sympathetic nervous system increases blood pressure, and blood pressure will continue to rise until mean arterial pressure will be higher than intracranial pressure. Because only in this case blood flow to the brain will be restored. Because if mean arterial pressure will be lower than intracranial pressure, prolonged brain ischemia will eventually result in ischemic infarction. So initially Cushing reflex characterized by hypertension and by tachycardia. But then, increased blood pressure is sensed by baroreceptors on aortic arch, and to decrease blood pressure, they increase parasympathetic nervous system outflow through nervus vagus. It decreases sinoatrial node activity, and this causes decrease in heart rate. Also, increased intracranial pressure causes compression of vagal nuclei. It stimulates activity of vagal nuclei that through nervus vagus increase parasympathetic nervous system outflow. And it's also decreased sinoatrial node activity, thereby it contributes to bradycardia. But interesting that hypertension remains due to increase in systemic vascular resistance. Because as we know, if mean arterial pressure become lower than intracranial pressure, arterioles become compressed and blood flow to the brain decrease. So it's vital for organism to maintain high blood pressure. And because heart rate decrease, obviously cardiac output decrease. So the only component that can maintain high blood pressure values is systemic vascular resistance. Also high yield to know that compression of vagal nuclei through nervus vagus increase parasympathetic nervous system outflow also to parietal cells in gastric mucosa. It stimulates by acetylcholine M3 receptors on parietal cells, and this results in increase in gastric acid secretion. Prolonged excessive gastric acid secretion eventually results in ulceration of gastric mucosa, and ulcers that develop due to increased intracranial pressure called Cushing ulcers. Also, at some point, intracranial pressure compresses brainstem, and because in brainstem located centers that control involuntary breathing, compression of brainstem disrupts normal function of respiratory centers. And this results in development of irregular respiratory pattern. Initially, it's shallow breathing with occasional periods of apnea, but after, as intracranial pressure becomes higher and brain herniation begins, it's progressed to agonal breathing that potentially culminates in apnea. So initially, activation of sympathetic nervous system cause hypertension and tachycardia. Then parasympathetic nervous system become activated and tachycardia change to bradycardia, but hypertension remains due to increase in systemic vascular resistance because it's vitally important to keep mean arterial pressure higher than intracranial pressure to maintain adequate brain perfusion. And as intracranial pressure progressively increases, it disrupts normal breathing, breathing become irregular, and as intracranial pressure increases further, it can progress to apnea. The clinical significance of this reflex is that if patient presents to emergency department with altered level of consciousness and has bradycardia and hypertension, these two symptoms can serve as indicators of increased intracranial pressure. But the problem is that these two symptoms are indicators of late-stage Cushing reflex that carries a poor prognosis for the patient. Also, it was estimated that patients who present to emergency department with concerns for increased intracranial pressure and has two of three signs of Cushing reflex, let's say hypertension and bradycardia, have been found to have almost twofold higher mortality than patients with normal and stable vital signs. So Cushing reflex, usually it's irreversible condition with a terminal prognosis for the patient, and the treatment of such patients aimed at rapid lowering of intracranial pressure. So treatment include elevation of the patient's head on 30-45 degrees, osmotic diuretics as mannitol, loop diuretics as furosemide, steroids, cerebrospinal fluid drainage, and also hyperventilation.